Greetings, I'm your host, Dr. Wolfula, and welcome to another entry of Wolfulaya News, my animated news series where I talk about the latest shit happening in the world of horror. Now, E3 is kicking off, and some games have been announced, I guess. But who gives a shit about Star Wars and Halo? No, what caught my eye during Microsoft's press conference was a total goddamn shock. A new Blair Witch game is coming to Xbox and PC. And I say new for a reason, because, believe it or not, this is not the first Blair Witch game. It's not even the second one, motherfucker. There have been 3 Blair Witch games released so far. It's fucking wild. The 3 original games were made directly in the wake of the original film to tie into the sequel, and they were all released within the same year of 2000. Might say something about the quality of the games, but it really does say something about the fast popularity of Blair Witch during the years of 99 and 2000 before the series suddenly faded away. Now, this new Blair Witch game's announcement is perfect timing for me. My live-action tether is, of course, editing a comprehensive Blair Witch Project review right now that will be ready soon, but why exactly is a new Blair Witch game happening? Especially since the series has pretty much faded away after poor receptions of both Book of Shadows Blair Witch 2 and the direct sequel slash reboot years later, which was also called Blair Witch. I don't really know exactly, but even though most people hate the original film, I'm a fan, especially the lore, and I'm looking forward to anything new from this franchise. Now, the game itself is being developed by, Bloober Team, who actually have quite the horror pedigree already, making Layers of Fear, which was decently received, so these aren't total randos making a Blair Witch game. Again, though, why? Well, it is the 20th anniversary of the first film, so there's that. But a game is a pretty big investment to make in commemoration of Blair Witch's anniversary, especially since the first film has fallen out of favor. It'd be easier and less expensive to make a new movie. I really don't know how this game could have happened, but here's a theory. This started out as an unrelated horror game in the woods, probably inspired by Silent Hill, Outlast, and Alan Wake, but it might have caught Microsoft's eye, who wanted the game to have some name recognition while still being its own thing. So they found that the Blair Witch myth was the best fit, got the rights, and used it. Of course, there's also the possibility that somebody at Lionsgate really wanted there to be a new fucking Blair Witch game while sitting on the series and not making a new film, but that's a little less likely to me. Though, there is apparently Lionsgate Games who's publishing this game, and they might have just looked through their catalog and were like, let's make this into a game, I guess. I looked into it, and the actual original creators of the Blair Witch Project didn't even seem to know that this game was being made. But let's talk about the actual game now. From what I can tell from the trailer, you play as Ellis, who used to be a cop and is now tasked with exploring the Black Hills Forest near Burkittsville, Maryland in 1996, 2 years after the events of the first film, searching for another missing person, a little boy. And you're joined by your little pupper, Bullet. Aww. Of course, if you go into those woods, especially with a video camera, you're pretty much fucked, and Ellis ends up lost and hunted by, tree monsters. The game is first person, which is good, but it doesn't quite have the same lo-fi look of the first film, which kind of makes me wish it was a constant video recording like in Slender, but then again, maybe this game wants to avoid comparisons. I will say, though, that the game has a nice atmosphere and looks very immersive, assuming all the shit in the trailer is actual gameplay footage and not pre-rendered. The game really captures the look of the Maryland woods seen in the original. It's very eerie, even during daylight. Of course, the game breaks away from the original film style by, actually having tree monster things populating the woods, which is something most people are gonna be down with, but I kinda prefer there being ambiguity with my Blair Witch stuff. This is a video game, though, and it'd be lame if it was just a walking simulator with some spooky noises in the background. I'd be down for it, but again, it'd be a turnoff for everybody if there were no tree monsters to fight. I'm not sure what the gameplay's gonna be like, but I'm glad it's going to be single player and story driven. It's not totally clear if this will be a full-on survival game, or if it'll just be a walking simulator with some scary stuff popping up and occasionally you have to run from a thing. Apparently there is a mechanic involving insanity, which sounds really fucking original, but according to the press release, the game is going to have a mechanic where it studies how you react to things in the game and makes adjustments based on how you play. I guess we'll see how that turns out. This might be code for, this game is short. We need to have something that encourages multiple playthroughs. Hopefully Blair Witch is a fun game. It does seem to have a dog mechanic, of course, so maybe you'll get to interact with Bullet and use him for combat or puzzles. Or maybe he'll just lead you to things, just a glorified quest marker. The trailer does have some Easter eggs showing a shitload of shacks in the woods, one of which has the handprints of kids on the walls and a tree dude in the corner. The shack doesn't look like Rustin Parr's house from the end of the original, but that house might show up in the game somewhere, and the tree monster does look like it could possibly be Mike from the first film, seeing as the game is 2 years later. Essentially, it's implied by the lore that the Blair Witch collects people and makes them her unwilling servants, kinda like Slenderman and his proxies, but more subtle. Actually, it's also implied in the original games and the newer film that the Blair Witch herself is just another minion. Basically, Ellie Kedward, the original Blair Witch, was blamed for the actions of an ancient evil entity called Hakaitomix by Native Americans, who haunts the Black Hills Forest. The weird tree alien thing you see at the end of the Blair Witch reboot is actually supposed to be Ellie Kedward, who is known as the Blair Witch, but she's not actually in charge of things. It's apparently this ancient, unseen demon that warps time and space within the Black Hills Forest, and this trailer seems to be playing off these concepts and doubling down on lost people being turned into tree monsters. The trailer didn't show a scene with the iconic stick figures physically present, but there is a screenshot with them, so they'll be there somewhere. I'm just hoping that the game will explore the mythos of the series in depth in a way a game can only do, messing with time and space, taking us to key moments like Coffin Rock, Rustin Parr, and even the disappearance of the students. It's a little weird how this game will fit in the overall mythos. It takes place in 96 before the first movie was released, and tells of more people disappearing in the woods after the three students disappeared in 94, so I don't know how, story-wise, this game will tie into those events. I hope this feels like a full-blown Blair Witch game with heavy references and connections to the series, because I didn't quite get that feeling from the trailer. It felt almost like this game would be set in its own universe that would reimagine the series, and I hope that's not the case. Overall, even though this is yet another Blair Witch thing that strays from the original film's ambiguous principles, I am excited for this Blair Witch game because of what it means for the series. A horror movie coming to a wider audience through games always brings with it a new appreciation for the original source. This Blair Witch game could reinvigorate the franchise. Or it could just be another random thing that comes out in the series that fails to capture the magic of the original movie and doesn't lead to anything. Again! Jeez, I hope not. The new Blair Witch game comes out on August 30th this year for Xbox One and PC, and I'll be getting it ASAP for Xbox. Thank you, Serafina, for the Xbox, by the way. Get well soon. I'll stream the game here, and there might just be a review up of it on the channel, too. We'll see how it plays out. Plays out. I'm so fucking funny. I just kill myself. I'm so fucking funny. If you like this video, like it. But if you loved it, subscribe for more and click the bell to keep track of future uploads and streams. Also, be sure to follow me on social media on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Dr. Wolfula. Finally, if you can, consider pledging to my Patreon where you'll support the channel and also get bonus streams, vids, and previews. Right now, I have an archive recording of my movie night live stream of Blair Witch 2 on my Patreon. But if you pledge to the $3 silver supporter tier, you'll get access to my movie night streams whenever they're live. I've been Dr. Wolfula, signing out.